The first question we had was about debugging and logging and how to make the development process a little bit smoother, and any advice you had about that.
Okay, yeah, that's a good question. Okay, so testing and debugging. Let's start with debugging first, because this one I actually do know how to do. First thing you want to do is in your file, you can say import logging. And this is the Python standard logging library. And it's already configured. So throughout your code, you can basically say logging.debug and just give this a string. And it'll print that in the console whenever this line is run, if you're in debug mode. Now, there's another command. There's another series of lines that I'm not going to write here. But if you look at the homework example I've put up, basically at the top of every of all of my source files, I have this line that's basically debug in capitals. And it basically what it does is it looks at the environment to see if I'm running in App Engine debug mode or in production. And so in production, this would be false. And in development, this value would be true. And this basically triggers all of these statements. So in production, we don't log all of these debug statements. But in development, we log, you know, everything that gets called by .debug gets printed to the console. Now, you can also say .error, logging.error. And this will print in production and in development. And so this is really handy. If there's a case where something went wrong, you know, the database didn't load right, or you know, some user error happened that you want to be aware of, even if it's happening in production, you can call logging.error. And then you can go into the admin console, which in App Engine, you go to appengine.com, and you can view, you can see all your admin stuff. You can actually look at all of your logs, and it'll include everything from error, but it won't include the stuff from debug. So that's a really helpful, you know, kind of way of seeing what's going on in your program. Of course, there's always print, is really helpful as well. Now, using things like the actual Python debugger is really hard with web apps because you're not running this module. There's this whole framework around it. So there are more complicated setups, but I found, you know, over the years that just having really good output to your console can go a long way. Now, for how to test, testing is really, really hard on web apps. There's a whole Udacity course on how to do testing. And a lot of your modules, a lot of the stuff that I would put in a utils file, like the hashing and the cookies and salting and all that stuff, you can just write functions to test that. There's a whole course. Now, for actually testing the behavior of your web app, that's a lot harder. You know, what we used to do at Reddit is we would deploy, you know, our code on one server, and we'd have an error log that was constantly scrolling in real time of all of our errors across all the app servers. And if that starts scrolling faster, we know there was a bug we just pushed into production. And we'd take that machine out of rotation and investigate. And that's, you know, I would say not the most professional way of doing things. However, I have on good authority that many of the largest websites in the world actually do things that way. Because testing websites is fairly non-deterministic. You just don't know what the errors are going to be. Or it's very hard to know what the errors are going to be. Another strategy we used on Reddit a lot is we would take, before doing a big deployment, we would capture, you know, the last 10,000 requests or so. And we would store those, and we'd replay them against our new app servers. Or in development, we just run all of those requests against the development app server. And if that produced an error, then we'd go investigate. That works really well, because we figure if the error is serious, we're going to see it immediately. And if it's not something we see immediately, it's probably not serious. And that's basically how we've done our testing. And every once in a while, something bad sneaks through. Fortunately, we've never lost data or really corrupted any data, because we try to do the best we can locally, but it's still a real challenge. And every website's a little different, so it's something you need to think pretty hard about, you know, what can go wrong and what happens if this piece of data is null or is full of malicious text. As long as you kind of think through that way, you can catch most errors while you're developing. So I hope that helps. It's an inexact science, I admit, but that's the way we've gotten by on a pretty large website.